Welcome to Dia de los Muertos. And if you don't speak Spanish, welcome to the Day of the Dead! So I've already created two almond shaped nails and I've coated them in the Urban Graffiti gel polish range in the colour of Bad Influence. That's you, that is. So it's like a very, very dark purple, almost black. Thought it was a very nice colour for what we're going to do today. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my colours out on my palette. I'm going to use this middle finger first. And I'm going to use the white, and this is obviously going to be the face. Just add a touch of water. So white with a little bit of water in, not a lot. And we're going to use this bottom part as the jawline, and this will be the rest of the face. And we're going to do two coats of this white, so we've got an even coverage of colour. And then on this one, we're going to do a different angle of the face. So I'm going to white out the face part of this. So I've took a bit of black paint and watered that down. And I'm just going to map out where the features are going to be. So I'm just going to start bringing this nose out now, so I've filled in the eyes a little. I'm just going to do the shape of the nose. So at the minute it looks like a skeleton, but we're obviously going to change that when the other features go in. Right, so we're going to start and do the mouth. So like the lips of the mouth, should I say. I'm going to use the white again to just add some teeth. So now we're going to put in the lines of the stitches in the mouth, which I don't fully understand. I'm going to add in some webbing to the top. Now I'm going to add the whites of the eyes. Now we're going to do the decoration on the cheeks and the forehead. Thinking round the eyes, the black sockets that we've done, we're just going to go round the outside with dots. It's just more of the decoration. We get a little bit of the ultramarine blue out just for the centre of the eyes, for the iris. I'm going to water that down. All I'm doing now is tidying up the edges of the eyes. And then we'll top coat it, and we're going to do the hair and the rosies with acrylic. I'm going to use the top and base from the Urban Graffiti gel polish range over the top of the paint. Make sure the paint is dry before you do this, but make sure you also cover every bit of painted artwork, else when you remove the sticky layer you'll lose your artwork. Make sure it's all covered, it's capped nicely. So I'm going to cure that in the lamp and then I can carry on with the other face. So that's all the painting done. What we're going to do now is do the hair and some roses in acrylic. So I've got in my dampened dish, I've got high speed because I want it to set quite quickly. I've got a small 3D brush Right, so I'm going to use Sapphire Satin, Pure Purple, and Passionate Purple, and also Primary Red, and Toxic Apple. So first of all, we're gonna do some swirly bits in the hair, and we're gonna use these different colours. So they are dark. So I'm going to start by doing a half moon shape here. Then we're going to layer into a swirl. We're going to layer using the different colours. I'm just pressing it out, and then eventually we'll get to a tight swirl in the middle. So this is sort of creating that sort of 50s swirl thing. What's it called? It's called something, isn't it, that hairdo?
I don't know, normal hairdos, oh, never mind 50s hairdos. Beehive?
No.
Ask the hairdresser.
Begins with a V,
something
roll.
Victory roll.
Yeah.
There you are. It's like a victory roll hairstyle. Just going to do some simple layering up this side, and then we'll add a rose. So layering it like this is just going to give it some movement. So I've just dipped the very tip of that bead into some of the purple, just to give it a bit of darkness. Just kind of touch, give it a little bit more purple right at the bottom. Pressing it out. Not too high, thinner at one end than it is at the other. Just using the purple quite wet just to add a bit more colour. So I'm just picking it up and rolling it out like this to create a tiny rose. We're going to put that just here. And I'm just going to make one more of those and put that there. And then we'll repeat this onto this nail as well. So I'm going to pick up a small bead of Toxic Apple, touch into the purple, and what that'll do is just give it a little bit of depth at the bottom. Pressing it out, and I'm just going to tickle it into the shape of a leaf. I'm going to keep it quite small. I will use a tool just to carve some detail into that. The little vines, and then I'm going to stick it here just under that little rose there. I'm using the Sapphire Satin acrylic to adhere it. I want something nice and dark. You could use clear if you wanted to. Give it a bit of a fold. So you've got a little roses and leaves. That one's all done. And now we're just going to do exactly the same on this nail here. Do the hair, some roses and some leaves. There you are, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video of the Day of the Dead, girls. I like a bit of Day of the Dead. Oh, like a bit of Day of the Dead. Mm. Rocking it out. I think that's a different alternative to a Halloween nail. Still quite funky. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and look in the description box if you want to find all the things that we've used today. Don't forget to check out our Instagram and our Facebook and my Snapchat, Kirsty Nails, and we will see you next time.